Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brethren, Christ Jesus, today Jesus invites all of us to live in the new wine of the Holy Spirit while we follow the tradition and the scriptural teaching from the Old Testament. Namely, we love our God and worship our God, God alone, at the same time loving our neighbor without leaving the old is good. At the same time, St. Paul invites us not to be judgmental on anyone, especially on the apostles and the ministers who serve the Lord. At the same time, leave everything to the hands of God for all our judgment, because the Lord is going to give us the reward. As we are invited today, offer this Mass as a thanksgiving Mass to our Sacred Heart of Jesus for the love that He has shown to us, to our family members. Let us respond to Him, accepting our sins and failures, asking the Lord to forgive us and become more and more closer to Him by really living His kingdom on this earth. I confess
unto you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my faults, through my most grievous faults. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Hymn number 90.
Lord, have mercy, you who bear
glory, glory to our God on high. Sing to Christ the Lord and Savior, seated there at God's right hand. Hear our prayer, O Lord, have mercy, you alone the Holy One. Glory, glory, sing His glory, glory to our God on high. Glory, sing to God the Father, glory to His only Son, glory to the Holy Spirit, glory to
us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conform to his image we may merit your share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
The Lord will reveal the intentions of men's heart. First reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 1 to 5. People must think of us as Christ's servants, stewards entrusted with the mysteries of God. What is expected of stewards is that each one should be found worthy of his trust. Not that it makes the slightest difference to me whether you, or indeed any human tribunal, find me worthy or not. I will not even pass judgment on myself. True, my conscience does not reproach me at all. But that does not prove that I am acquitted. The Lord alone is my judge. There must be no passing of premature judgment. Leave that until the Lord comes. He will light up all that is hidden in the dark and reveal the secrets, intentions of men's heart. Then will be the time for each one to have whatever praise to be he deserves from God. The word of the Lord. Your response. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. If you trust in the Lord and do good, then you will live in the land and be secure. If you find your delight in the Lord, He will grant your heart's desire. Your response. Commit your life to the Lord. Trust in Him and He will act so that your justice breaks forth like the light, your cause like the noonday sun. Your response. Then turn away from evil and do good, and you shall have a home forever, for the Lord loves justice and will never forsake his friends. Your response. The salvation of the just come from the Lord. They stronghold in time of distress. The Lord helps them and delivers them and saves them, for their refuge is in them. Your response. Kindly stand for the gospel acclamation. the world, says the Lord. Anyone who follows me will have the light of life.
Will have the light of life.
Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Fifth chapter of Saint Luke, verses 33 to 39. The Pharisees and the scribes said to Jesus, "John's disciples are always fasting and saying prayers, and the disciples of the Pharisees too. But yours go on eating and drinking." Jesus replied, "Surely you cannot make the bridegroom's attendants fast while the bridegroom is still with them. But the time will come, the time for the bridegroom to be taken away from them. That will be the time when they will fast." He also told them this parable: "No one tears a piece from a new cloak to put it on an old cloak. If he does, not only will he have torn the new one, but the piece taken from the new will not match up the old. And nobody puts new wine into old wine skins. If he does, the new wine will burst the skins and then run out, and the skins will be lost. No new wine must be put into fresh skins. And nobody who has been drinking old wine wants new. The old is good," Jesus says. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to your Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brethren, Christ Jesus, today's gospel speaks about doing the right things at the right time. Fasting, feasting can be done according to the need of the hour. And of course, people have fasting on various purposes. People like me, if you ask me to fast, okay, I fast to reduce my weight or weight management. Some of the youngsters, they do. But it is that one type of fasting. There are people who fast for the purpose of coming out from a certain bad habits or addicted to certain things. They also fast. And there is another category of people who think, in order to understand who I am, where is it that I am walking to? Am I walking to the right direction of God, or I am deviated? To in order to understand, go deeper into the heart of a person, people go for fasting. So various types of fasting there. So that is why we say we do things at the right time and the right things. Jesus invites us. So understand the purpose of the mystery of Jesus Christ. Accordingly, you live that mystery in your life. And naturally, Matthew Gospel, we will read, from the treasures that are hidden in the Old Testament, that are explicitly visible in the New Testament, we should be able to take the treasures of the old and the new, and that will be possible for a person who has understood the mystery of salvation. So that is the first thing we would like to say. Lord, give us me the grace to understand you better, because the New Testament truths are hidden in the Old Testament, and that becomes a complementary. And that is why Jesus says, you are asked to worship the Lord with your heart, mind, and soul, and you are asked to love your neighbor.
these two commandments will never go away from the core of your religious practices, rather than fasting, that is good, but it has its own relevance when it has to be done. And he gives one example there. When the bridegroom is there, when the marriage function is there, that is not the time for fasting, that is the time to feasting. So enjoyment. But at the same time, Jesus gives them indication that the bridegroom will be taken away, and he forecast his death and resurrection. That time certainly his disciples are going to fast and mourn for his death. And that is the reason he says, now anything, when you judge people, don't be judgmental without knowing their background, their situation, and try to put yourself into the other people's lives and experience them. And then, if at all you want to judge, you judge. But it would be always wise, leave the judgment to God, that would take place, and the appropriate time, God will reward them. And that is what St. Paul advises today in the first reading. Lastly, my dear friends, Jesus says, don't try to patch up. I'm not speaking about the patching up when you have misunderstanding or hurt feelings. Try to patch up in the family, husband and wife and children. That is quite good. That is moved by the Spirit. What Jesus wants to tell us today, when you try to patch up with my old cassette and I buy some new cloth and stitch it here because there is a hole, it will not match up. The reason why he says, as though you do not know, I do not know, we know this truth. He is bringing this parable in order to tell us half-hearted effort from our side to follow him as a disciple will never give us any purpose. If we really want to follow him, as he said, take up the cross and follow me, and that would bring us salvation. So all our spiritual activities, starting from the first Friday, and all the activities, if it has got a relevance towards the understanding of the mystery of God in our life, the purpose for which you and I are created in this world, in this family, in a particular profession, then it is clear that we are able to have a real living in the new wine of the Holy Spirit. Ultimately, dear friends, today we pray to the Holy Spirit that we should be able to receive the anointing of the Holy Spirit, so that we will be looking at things in the new perspective. At the same time, we will give up the old self in our lives and receive the new self of Christ within us. For that, today we shall pray the good Lord, the Sacred Heart of Jesus, who has been loving us, who has been guiding us, may he rule our hearts and minds. May he always be a king of our conversation, our hospitality. May he be our master of our work and whatever we do in this world. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, Father of mercies, who, because of the great love with which you loved us, with untold goodness gave us your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that being perfectly united with him, we may offer you worthy homage through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the church sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end, we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus was betrayed and he entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, the Mabal, our Archbishop, and bishops and clergy. Remember your servants, Father Matthew, Anthony and Elsie, Raj and Jude, Mark Matthew and his grandparents, Keegay, and all other souls whom you have called today from this world on this day. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like this may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Antony of Padua, our patron saint, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. And with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, especially when we want to patch up without going into the deeper problems, and inspire, taking the Holy Spirit inspiration, coming out from the old evil tendencies, not knowing and living fully on this earth. Graciously grant peace in our days, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Dear friends, the greatest gift that God gives us, especially when we adore the Sacred Heart of Jesus, that as he has poured out his blood and send his Holy Spirit upon us and anointed us, the greatest gift that he gives us is peace. Let us become worthy of his gift, that is gift of peace. Let us pray for us, for our families, and for our neighborhood to receive this peace. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins and limitations, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Have mercy on us, Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that is under my roof, but only so that my soul shall be happy.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen. Amen. Hymn number 362, 362.
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Thus says the Lord, let whoever is thirsty come to me and drink. Streams of living water will flow from within the one who believes in me. Let us rise for the final prayer. Act of consecration to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. O adorable Heart of Jesus, the tenderest, the most amiable, the most generous of all hearts, penetrated with gratitude at the sight of thy benefit, I come to consecrate myself wholly and unreservedly to thee. I wish to devote all energies to propagating thy worship and winning, if possible, all hearts to thee. Receive my heart this day, O Jesus. Rather take it, change it. Make it humble, gentle, by inflaming it, the fire to thy life. Hide it in thy divine heart with all that love thee and are consecrated to thee. Never permit me to take my heart from thee again. Let me rather die than greet thy adorable heart. Thou knowest, O Heart of Jesus, that the desire of my heart is to love thee always, to be wholly thine in life and in earth, in time and eternity. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Of Jesus, most sacred heart of Jesus, most sacred heart of Jesus. Let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth, receiving the anointing of the Holy Spirit in the new wine, and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Hymn number 507, 507. Sweet Heart of Jesus, Fount of love and mercy, blessings to implore. Oh, touch our